What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I am back. You know, in order to be great in anything in life, you need one word, and that is passion. Everyone say passion. Yeah, that's right. So you need passion to be great in this game and also in anything you want to do. So I encourage you, get passionate about the things you want to be great at. It is a game changer for sure. So DreamHack Anaheim is coming up really, really soon. And with the excitement, we thought it'd be interesting to go all the way back and come up with a list of the top 10 best Fortnite LAN performers of all time. In case you don't know, LAN events are tournaments played in person. That means, you know, people aren't competing in the cozy comfort of their homes. They have to travel, you know, play on unfamiliar hardware, and deal with all sorts of external factors. While we're not saying performing at LAN events is, you know, the be-all and end-all of skill, they're still just an excellent way to see who can pop off when conditions aren't ideal. But quickly, I want to ask you guys this question. Have you guys ever played at a LAN? You know, it could be the Fortnite or, you know, for any other game. If you have, let us know where and how it went. And just before we get started, if you guys want to be the best players in this video and get good at Fortnite, you got to check out ProGuys.com. You know, we've got experienced pros waiting to coach you guys on your journey and courses written by the likes of Mongrel and Benji Fishy. Like the video and subscribe to the channel, then head on over to ProGuys.com to get started. Ladies and gentlemen, it's about that time. All right, all around the world, I want you to say this with me. It's time to sit back, come on, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. Y'all better bring this out right now. It's that Bunch of Crunch, and let's get this going. Coming in at number 10, we've got Somm. Okay, so even though Somm isn't, you know, at the pinnacle of his mechanical skill, he's no doubt one of the smartest players out there. You know, his ability to execute brilliant strategies helped him secure second place and close to $2 million at the World Cup. And that's what I call, guys, putting your mind to work. While that was his most famous LAN moment, you know, it definitely wasn't his last. You know, way before the World Cup, he attended PAX West to play in the Summer Skirmish Finals. And regardless of it, you know, being his first time in a major Fortnite tournament, he still did pretty well. Then Somm played at the WSOE3, a 100,000 duo event in California, where with a solid performance, he secured a fourth place finish. Somm ended up also getting invited to the Secret Skirmish, and most recently he took the extended journey across the world to play in the Australian Open. All in all, guys, you know, Somm has the experience and results needed to back up this number 10 spot. Next up, it's Team Solo Mid's Vinny1x. Although Vinny's not the most, you know, popular TSM member, he definitely is one of the most consistent, you know, when it comes to slaying out in front of a big crowd. His first success in a major tournament was actually at a LAN event. There, he put up dominating performances, man, in both the heat and final stages to end up finishing third and taking home over $80,000. 2 months later, he played at the WSOE3, but sadly finished in 21st place, one spot outside the money. You know, I'm sure that must have disappointed Vinny, as it would anybody, but, you know, like the good competitor he is, he used it as motivation. He went on to earn decent placements in both Secret Skirmish events, got signed to TSM, then went on to his most significant win yet, the ESL Katowice Royale. There, he put an incredibly consistent performance in the solo portion, beating out the likes of Mitro, 72 Hours, and Ghost Aiden to take home the first place prize. Oh, and he also got third place in the duo event as well, as if winning solos wasn't enough. Although Vinny doesn't stream, be on the lookout for him at DreamHack Anaheim. Okay, guys, so at number 8, it's the famous Swiss player, Kinstar. Now, you know, Europeans were at a disadvantage when it came to participating in all the major events run by Epic since they were held in the States. But it turns out that Kinstar was attending and winning LANs even before most NA players, who even travel next door to France and play in even small events run by orgs like, you know, Lion Esports and DreamHack, earning a couple of wins. Most players would be afraid to commit and travel for tournaments given the fact, you know, that the game was still somewhat new, but not Kinstar. You know, this guy, he played in nearly every event he could, managing to win a couple and then placing well in others. And with a story similar to Vinny's, man, Kinstar earned his first 5-digit prize at ESL Katowice. Then he went on to qualify for both the Solo and Dual World Cup, and while his performance wasn't substantial, he did place, you know, 26th and 23rd, which is not too shabby. You know, and after the World Cup, Epic started doing more online events. And so Kinstar really hasn't showed us many opportunities, you know, what he's made of on a big stage. But when he gets the chance again, I'm sure he's gonna put on a show and he's gonna stun us all. All right, guys, so at number 7, it's 100 Thieves Cease. Cease is a veteran of Fort Lylands. He first made a name for himself at PAX West during week 8 of the summer skirmish. There, he placed 16th and took home a cool 11 grand. Yeah, no big deal. But in his next event, TwitchCon, he and his duo partner Elevate choked pretty bad. You know, they finished near the bottom at 46th place, but I guess in terms of prize money, it was the same as finishing 11th. So, hey, I guess, you know, I don't think that kept him up at night. Then at WSOE3, that's when he really popped off. You know, despite getting 0 wins across the 6 games, Cease still got enough kills to propel himself to first place. And Cease's most significant run came during the World Cup Finals, where we were all glued to our screens that one weekend in July, man. But in case you can't remember, Cease and Elevate went hard in duos all the way to third place. You know, in terms of cheddar, you know, Cease now has over $1 million in earnings from LAN events alone, making him one of the top competitors in history. At number 6, it's the legend himself. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Booga. Now, I'm not gonna lie about this. If Booga had won the Fortnite World Cup, he wouldn't be on this list. You know, before that life-changing occasion, he hadn't even played in many LAN events. The only one where he had any sort of result was the Microsoft Store NA Championship. And it's debatable if you even want to call that a LAN. While players did have to travel and compete in unfamiliar environments, matches were still played online. But, you know, whatever you want to call it, his squad came in second place. And that's where Booga first got a taste of that sweet, sweet Fortnite money. Then, of course, there was his win at the World Cup. You know, I feel like we can't say much that hasn't already been said. But for Booga to perform so consistently across all 6 matches and close out the event with nearly double the points of second place makes it one of the best showings we've ever seen. All right, so moving on at number 5, we've got the French icon himself, Skyte. You know, when Skyte wasn't, you know, ducking it out against the competition online, he was building a name for himself by traveling around Europe and dominating local events. He got a bronze prize at DreamHack Tours 2018, second place at Valenciennes Game Arena, and another at 10,000 Euro tourney run by Lion Esports. You know, I think there were another 8 or so events Skyte participated in before his 10 at the World Cup, giving him the highest participation rates of any player on our list. Okay, look, I get it. You know, those minor events don't really mean much. So how did Skyte do at the World Cup? Well, on those fateful summer days, Skyte LAN's experience proved useful. He and his duo partner barely snagged the 225K prize by finishing 10th. And the next day, he went on to earn another $500,000 by placing 7th in solos. You know, his most recent placement at DreamHack Winter in Sweden was 54th, you know, which is slightly below average. But they're gonna be more in the future, right? So, you know, I think Skyte and his fan base still have a lot to look forward to. All right, guys, so in 4th place, it's NRG's Epic Whale. What's different with Epic Whale compared to the others on our list is that, you know, his first ever Fortnite LAN event was the World Cup. Not exactly, you know, the low pressure situation someone would prefer for their first time. Still, he managed to do exceptionally well. He finished 3rd place in solos and I think something like 12th in duos, crazy. When you average those 2 placement points, he did better than any other double qualifier in New York that weekend. You know, that right there is enough to earn him this spot. And after the World Cup, you know, Epic Whale hasn't had a single weak performance. At TwitchCon 2019, he finished 13th place. And most recently, at the Australian Open, he showed the Aussies what NA West players can do and took home 12th place. You know, had Epic Whale been of age during the early days of LAN events, we think he'd have way more accolades under his belt. But you know, all things considered, he's definitely a premier competitor. All right, guys, so hang on tight for this one. We're almost at the end. For number 3, though, we got Ghost Bizzle. All right, so Ghost Bizzle, you know, probably has the best LAN result in all of Fortnite's early history. You know, the consistency, guys, was just unreal. Let me tell you that right now. For starters, he got 2nd place at PAX West, then 4th place at TwitchCon a month later. He and his squad won the Microsoft Store Championship, the same one Booga got 2nd in. Then at the Secret Skirmish, Bizzle got 4th in duos and the gold prize for solos. You know, it's no surprise that Bizzle had the most tournament earnings before the World Cup. And speaking of the World Cup, guys, Bizzle qualified for solos, but only managed to finish 23rd. You know, while that's not a horrible performance, it's just, you know, wasn't the same top 5 placement. So many of his fans were just used to seeing, right? Ever since then, you know, Bizzle hasn't taken any solos seriously really anymore. I don't know, you know, I just think he's not really a fan of them. You've gotta have a cracked out playstyle if you wanna do well nowadays, and Bizzle doesn't really roll like that. If it wasn't for his, you know, lack of participation, you know, we'd probably place him higher. But still, you know, given Bizzle's incredible achievements, he deserves the 3rd place spot. And for our runner-up, ladies and gentlemen, it's the World Cup Duels champion, Nightrox. Okay, so no one really knew about Nyrox before the World Cup, but it turns out that this super skilled Norwegian has been putting on a clinic at LAN since 2018. His first showing was at the Polaris Pro Series, where he won the second place prize. Then he traveled to Sweden to participate in Norrspan Arena and DreamHack Winter 2018. He even went out to Spain and France for more, and he just couldn't get enough. This dude was all over the place. Of course, you know, Nyrox's first place finish with Aqua, you know, at the World Cup is, you know, what he's most recognized for, right? No one saw it coming, but he definitely deserved it. The man played out of his mind, dude. Comeback stories, you know, are amazing, and, you know, those back-to-back wins were so satisfying to watch. Since then, Nyrox played in both the DreamHack Winter 2019 and the Australian Open, earning 19th and 4th place in those solo events, respectively. You know, both of those events were extremely competitive, and he still managed to pull through with top results, which easily solidifies his spot on this list. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, the top Fortnite competitive LAN player of all time is GhostSaf. Since the very beginnings, you know, Saf has been an absolute force in the North America scene. You know, for a while though, his showings wouldn't really be too noteworthy. He finished 20th at PAX West for the Summer Scrimmage Finals, then 12th at TwitchCon. And at WSOE3, Saf and his duo partner Zate were the runner-ups. Then when 2019 came, Saf once overall proved that he was one of the best players the NA scene had to offer. You know, during the Secret Skirmish, a clutch performance made him take first place in the duo competition, as well as second place in the solo event. Then just 16 days later, okay, so he and Zate flew to Poland for the Katowice Royale and showed Europe that the turf really didn't matter. They absolutely rolled over the competition and took home first place. During the World Cup, Saf and Zate held a commanding lead until a few, you know, unlucky moments bumped them down to finish fourth. Most recently, Saf placed 29th at the Australian Open, arguably his worst placement in a LAN event. Still, he has an incredible career with amazing consistency, and we really can't wait to see what he does next season. Quick shout out to all the duo partners that didn't make this list. You know, guys like Zate, Elevate, and Zexroll, you know, they're all just as nutty on LAN. But, you know, we try to avoid picking multiple players from the same teams just to give you guys a bit of more variety. But anyway, guys, that's our list. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, let us know if you agree, you know, with this list or not. If there's someone we didn't bring up, just drop a comment below letting us know who it is. Once again, we'll see you next time.